What's up? Hey, girl.
What's up?
What you doing? How you doing?
Too close. Well, you're not too close, but...
How about now?
Fine.
Howdy, y'all.
Hi, guys.
It's Ryan.
And I'm Angela.
From RNA Music.
That's where we be.
Deep in the heart of Texas. Well, something happened to our backdrop. I don't know what happened. All right.
Reasons.
Stuffs. Welcome to another FAQ Friday. This is number 10.
Whoa.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
How about that? All right.
It's been 10, really?
Yes, absolutely.
Wow.
Okay. Well, last week was number 9, so I assume this is number 10.
We should do like a video montage where it's like all the little in slow motion.
That would be fun. Or a lot of work for me to do editing. Or both. All right, to the questions. Now, we missed a couple of questions last week, but it's because I'm scrolling through them on the iPad, and apparently it leaves off a few, so if we leave them off, I'm so sorry.
Sorry.
Tim had one. Tim had one from asking about the question that we said we wouldn't answer, but I believe we said... We're not going to tell you what the question is.
Tim!
So there you go. No, you don't get to ask what the question is that we were surprised somebody's asked. So
use your thinker.
So, there you go. So there's that one.
There's that one.
Okay. Scrolling. All right, the first one that I have on my iPad is from Mike... S4628. Hi Mike. Ryan, any guitars that you consider a guilty pleasure? By that I mean any unusual guitars or budget guitars that you own or have owned that you just enjoyed but aren't really something you'd show off to others. For example, I have a Yamaha Pacifica I bought as a beater, but yes. Ended up really liking it a lot, even through a 112, even though it's a 112 model basic Pacific. Guilty pleasure guitars. It'd be like a Hello Kitty guitar or something.
That what?
Yeah, there's these pink guitars with Hello Kitty on it people play heavy metal on. And so it's like, you would not have something like that, but then you're proud to have it. I don't know. I don't have a Hello Kitty guitar.
No.
Nor do I want one. I don't really have any ones that are guilty pleasures. All the guitars that I own.
He's gotten permission to have. It's funny because it's true.
I'm pretty happy about all of them. You know, there's no real goofy ones or anything like that. I have one that might be. Will you hold that, please? Thank you. I have one that's kind of funny.
It's not a guilty pleasure.
It's a little harmony. Just a toy, a little guitar, really, but I never play it. I just have it because it was my very first guitar that I got as a kid. I didn't even start playing guitar when I got it. It was just like a goofy present, I guess.
Because every little country boy needs a guitar. A guitar, like they say around here.
Country boy.
Yeah, you are.
It's true. I grew up on a farm. I grew up on a ranch. So it's, I keep it. I have it even hanging up on my wall just because it's a memento. I don't even know how old I was when I got it. I didn't really start playing until I was 12 or 13. I probably got this when I was 9 or 10. So, but other than that, no. Every guitar I have, I'm pretty happy with. I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed of any of them.
No. Yeah, there's not really anything that we purchased that are like, I shouldn't have done that.
Hope no one finds out.
No.
Hope no one finds out I listen to Beyonce.
What?
No. Put a ring on it.
He did.
Put a ring on it. My ring, my ring, my ring.
Okay.
So, yeah, no, not really. Pacificas are great guitars, too. Mm-hmm. Nothing to be ashamed of. Thanks, Mike. Next question is from The John 101. Not to be confused with Big John. This is The John. Gotcha. Hey, took delivery of my RNA exclusive Chapman Guitar Silver Ink t-shirt. Yeah, a few days ago. Thanks. Mm-hmm. Thank you for sending it all the way to England for me. Hey, no problem. We've sent a couple of t-shirts to Englandshire the last several weeks. Thank you for ordering a shirt all the way from Texas. So, The John's question. How did you first hear about Rob and Chapman Guitars, and what made you want to become a Chapman dealer?
Good question.
Good question. Well,
the John.
The John.
Yes.
The Duke. The John Wayne Duke. Well, I think I first heard about Rob, it was probably back in 2010-ish. We started RNA Music, technically, legally on paper, January 2010, mm-hmm. although we were working on stuff in 2009.
Yeah.
I started my second YouTube channel, which was strictly for the store, probably March 2010. No, maybe February. I don't know. I had a YouTube channel, basically.
Early 2010.
Yeah, to advertise the store and just, you know, advertise lessons and get a good Google listing. And so that's when I really started watching a lot of YouTube. I'd watched it for years and followed a few people before that, but never come across Rob. But then when I was really active on YouTube, I think I found him doing Orange stuff because I was an Orange dealer. One of the first companies I picked up was Orange. And so I think I was looking around for some Orange stuff and I came across his videos and I thought those were pretty funny, actually, the early ones. So I started watching Rob's videos back then and then joined the forum a little bit after that. Mm-hmm. Probably lurking for a while, then actually joined the forum. And I just really liked what he did. I thought he was pretty funny. And I liked his music.
Mm-hmm.
And that's actually the first time that it occurred to me that I could use YouTube for the just in advertising lessons and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Doing reviews and just having fun with it.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then that was about the time Chapman Guitars, they started the early phases. I remember, I think they had already had the vote for the ML1. Not too long after I found out about Rob, and then of course followed him for a long time, and you know, being kind of starting off as a fan really first, mm-hmm. and then getting involved on the forum and meeting all the guys there, had some Skype lessons with Rob way back, which is really cool. Got to know him a little bit, and we even talked about, because I had a small store in Texas, we talked about me or RNA Music becoming a Chapman dealer like 2 years ago,
mm-hmm.
like something like that. So we were one of the first people. And at the time, it was not much different than it is now because it's factory direct and, you know, you got to order a certain number of models and all that kind of stuff back then.
Mm-hmm.
Would love to have done it, but it was just wasn't quite within reach at the time. So I really liked the idea behind the collaborative design process and the fact that Rob includes the people in the whole thing with the guitars, and nobody else does that. You know, Gibson's not going to put out a poll and go, hey guys, what do you want to make?
No,
they don't do that. They don't care. They're going to build for you what they think you want to buy. Mm-hmm. And so from the very beginning, I liked Rob as a person, and I liked his YouTube channel, I liked his personality and how funny he was, and then I liked everything about the Chapman Guitars process, and had deep down wanted to become a dealer. From way back, we were talking about the other day about,
mm-hmm.
you know, we were talking about this and Rob asked me about being a dealer like 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And then here we are nearly 2 years later and we're going to get our guitars probably in like the next 4 days.
So exciting.
So excited. We should have our first order of Chapman guitars.
Yeah.
Probably by Monday. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if that answers the question, but that's a little bit of the story.
Yeah, without making it too long because we'd be here forever.
Yeah, I could talk about details. I could talk about Chapman guitars for forever. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's about it. Thanks, John. All right, next question comes from Joe Boxer. Hi.
Hi. How are you, sir?
Favorite getaway trip / vacation? I just went to Darien Lake, Kingdom Bound, 2014 Rock. Awesome. I assume that means favorite one we've actually had, because last week we answered, where would we go?
Where would we go, yes.
Pat asked us about that. We said Disneyland.
Disney World.
World. Sorry.
Disneyland is great, but Disney World is what I'm used to. So I'm not saying better. But
what's our favorite getaway trip vacation that we've had?
I think it's a toss-up between both included Alabama to me. Mm-hmm. I think one is when we went to Alabama and we got to go to the
Rocket Museum.
The Rocket Museum with our boys, and we got to see all the original Star Wars outfits and memorabilia, and it was like the actual outfits that people wore
from the movie.
Episode 4, 5, and you know, and 1, 2, and 3. 4, 5, and 6, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So yeah, I mean,
that was pretty
everything. Cool. All the models and all that kind of stuff. So that one,
that was pretty cool.
And getting to go to the NAMM. The year later, I think we went to NAMM.
Winter, summer NAMM.
Summer Nashville. NAMM. Nashville NAMM. That was fun.
That was fun.
Yeah, because we got to go together and
just the two of us.
Just the two of us.
Angela's parents lived in Huntsville, Alabama, and so for the last several years, we would go to Huntsville during the summer and spend some time with Nana and Pawpaw. And that's where the there's the NASA Space Camp Rocket Museum is in Huntsville.
It's pretty darn cool.
And they have different exhibits every year, and they had the Star Wars exhibit, and that was pretty sweet.
It was pretty stinking sweet.
And I think the next year, we came back to Alabama. Well, Nashville, Tennessee, is only like an hour and a half north of Huntsville.
Yeah.
So we were visiting family anyways, and then Angela and I went up to
Summer
NAMM. That was fun.
And then whenever I got to go, went up and went to Ohio, which is a 7-hour journey from Huntsville, Alabama. So it was like altogether 19 hours worth of driving. But we got to see a lot of family. Hi, Darlene. And cousin
Ohio
Kim.
Family.
Ohio family.
Kim. Crazy Kim.
And Ryan got to meet face-to-face with Robert Baker for the first time. That was fun.
Of YouTube fame.
Hi, Robert.
Hi, Robert.
Involved Alabama, because that was just our, you know, way of, you know, travel. But
and then we went to Teresa's wedding in Virginia.
Yeah, and going to my friend's wedding, I got to sing.
Which just took forever to get to. And we drove through Alabama again.
So that's what I'm saying, like, all of our trips that we've taken, usually as family, that have been, like, extensive.
Yeah.
We're through Alabama, because my parents are great babysitters.
They are.
They're wonderful.
Phenomenal. Thank God we have them.
Phenomenal.
To leave our kids with.
Yes. So, yeah.
Hey.
I would say that. What would you say?
All of those. We had a little marriage getaway thing at Dry Gulch USA, which was
great. Yeah. Our 7-year wedding anniversary. Yeah.
Yeah.
I forgot about that.
I didn't.
It's been 8 years ago.
It was great. That was nice, because it was like a weekend.
Yeah, it was.
With no children on the set.
I know.
Like, it looks like gun smoke there.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
It's really awesome. Check out drygulchusa.com, and you'll see what we're talking about. It's pretty phenomenal.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
I think that's it.
Yeah. We're not world travelers.
Yeah, we don't travel very much.
And you know, I don't think, like, maybe once we've been to the beach, but it was Galveston.
Yeah, that was lame.
Yeah.
Well, it wasn't awesome. It wasn't terrible.
No, it wasn't.
We went on an aircraft carrier. There was an aircraft carrier we went on or something.
That was a galaxy. Did we actually go on it?
We didn't go on it because we went Poe.
Yeah. We don't take a lot of vacations, like typical vacations people take.
Hey, yeah, we never really get to because A, we don't have the money, B, we don't have the time, so.
And we own our own business, so it's hard to take a whole week off and go somewhere when you're like a business owner.
Yeah. We're not stupid. We don't like accumulating debt, so we don't charge to go places.
Yeah.
So.
We're going to go to England, though.
Yes, but we're not going to charge to go there.
No, we're not going to go to do it. So. Thanks, Joe. Yeah. I think we've yet to have our favorite getaway trip.
Yeah, not so. Yet. Well,
all right.
There you
go. Next question, please. Fade to Hollow. I love your send-off. Keep the music alive. Thank you. I enjoy it, too. But what do you think would happen if the music did die? Oh, and you are mistaken, sir. I am a Blake Shelton fan somewhat on occasion. LOL. See, it doesn't sound like a hardcore Blake Shelton.
No. Not just so, somewhat. But you didn't get offended, did you?
Yeah, you didn't mind.
Mm-hmm.
You're probably happy that I played it.
That's great. You're all like, yes, my jam.
What do you think would happen if the music did die? Well, if there was no music, I think the world would end.
I think it would. I think the only thing that's keeping the world on its axis is music.
I think everyone would go insane and it would become really, really violent and we'd all kill each other.
I think so too.
It'd be the end of the world as we know it, which is a song. So there you go. Thanks, Fade to Hollow. Next question. I had to refresh my newsfeed here. Big John. Not the John, but Big John says, yes. Ryan and Angela, how do you feel about Mr. James Hetfield hunting controversy? There is none. Let me say I used to hunt, but can't anymore due to foot crush injury back in 05. Ouch! Dang. Are these Metallica fans who are against hunting or carrot-eating, tree-hugging John Wayne haters? Please, thanks for the input. P.S. Thanks for the input. Song and James had the same birthday. Awesome. All right, as far as the James Hetfield hunting controversy, how do I feel about it? I don't care at all. I think it's great, you know.
I didn't know anything about it. He had to tell me.
I had to explain it to
what her. It was. Because there was that girl on Facebook that's been circulating around about...
Big game hunter.
That she went out and did a big game. Everybody was in uproar. They're mad. Like, those beautiful beasts.
She killed the lion. They were fired up about it.
You know.
I don't care that James hunts. I mean, that's fine. I mean, I'm from Texas.
Yeah, I don't like to hunt, but not because I think it's barbaric or anything like that. I just don't like it.
Yeah.
I don't want to.
I don't like hunting you.
You don't hunt me.
Fuck you. All right. I'm not a hunter either, really. I mean, I don't go out and hunt deer and hogs and stuff. Mm-mm. I'm not against it either. I mean... No. That's great. I just don't like to clean stuff. I don't mind shooting stuff, but I don't want to go take a knife and gut it and clean it and get guts and blood all over me.
Yeah.
So I'm not down with the cleaning. And I think if you're going to go kill an animal, you know, to hunt, to eat it, that's part of the deal. You got to clean it and skin it and all that stuff yourself.
And you need to use all of it.
Yeah, I'm not
into Native American about it. Come on.
I'm not into the blood stuff. So I do love shooting guns. I'll kill cans all day long. And people,
those cans are going down.
If they break into my home, that's what I meant to say after that. But, yeah. But I have no problem with people who hunt.
No.
That's fine. Mm-mm. Doesn't bother me.
If they want to do what they want to do, they want to do what they're going to do it anyways.
Yeah, I think all the people protesting Metallica playing that festival in England because James was the voice of a documentary about hunting. That's just silly.
Of all things that are happening in this world to complain about, really?
Yeah.
Come on.
You got people being executed in countries because they believe in Jesus being beheaded. And you're fired up about somebody killing...
Talking.
Some animals.
Talking.
Talking about killing animals.
Lord.
Seriously.
Help us all.
Seriously.
Jiminy Crickets.
Oh my Lord. All right.
Perspective, folks.
Perspective. That's our word.
Perspective.
For the decade. Or two.
Woo!
Yeah. So thanks, Big John. Not a non-issue for us.
Non-issue.
Yeah. Carl Stacey really enjoyed watching this. Good list of five things. Oh, yeah. Good. Mm-hmm. That wasn't a question. Thanks. Carl! Carl! So awesome. You should come check out Denver. Maybe I will. Maybe we will. You guys are hilarious. Rock on. Thank you. I didn't feel like we were particularly funny last week.
I didn't either.
Like, outside of the ordinary?
No. I don't know. I don't know what they're referring to.
I'm not sure. Maybe it was just a good day. All right. I think this is the last question. Crystal okay. One Mage. I keep wanting to say image, but it's Crystal One Mage. Skyrim. Hello, Ryan and Angela. I'm watching you all the way from New Zealand. Yeah.
Hey.
That's Maori for the land of the long white cloud. Yeah.
That's nice.
I don't know
I
what.
I like that.
I can't pronounce that. I'm Jason Wright. I have lots of guitars, but I still love buying damaged guitars and fixing them up. My question is, if you could only have one passive humbucker pickup in the bridge position of your electric guitar, what pickup would you install? Thanks very much, and I await your answer with bated breath.
I can't do that.
Wait for it. Have a great weekend, Jason. P.S. The guitar in question would mainly be used for blues and old school rock. LOL. Bye now. Take care. You know, I changed my answer on the question about if we would move to, like, Switzerland or to New Zealand in a video with Patrick Gray from Australia, because New Zealand's awesome, and y'all have Lord of the Rings.
Lots of hobbits.
Yeah, and the countryside is awesome. So,
it's
yeah.
Gorgeous.
Gorgeous. All right, if I could have one passive humbucker, it would be... that one, right there, which is a Seymour Duncan Custom. It's so awesome, you have to say it twice. It's not the custom.
New York, New York.
It's the custom. Yeah. I like it. It's a great pickup. It does all that stuff good. It does rock and blues and can even do some hard rock metal-y stuff if you need it to with the right amp. And it's just a great all-around bridge pickup. Not too lame. Not too hot, just great pickup. I like it. I only have it in one guitar. But if I were going to add any other, if I were going to swap any bridge pickups out on some of these for a passive, that's probably my favorite passive. That guitar has a 59 in the neck and a custom in the bridge.
Nice.
I know. It is nice.
I know. That's why I said it. It sounded nice.
It is.
I have custom, no idea custom. What you're talking about.
Sounds swanky, doesn't it?
But custom, it sounds pretty custom. Cool.
Yep, so that would be my choice, Crystal One Mage, Jason Wright. Oh, there was a...
Family Band.
Yeah, Demo 28, or Dimo 28.
Demo.
Demo. Demo 28 asks, really like the weekly vids, thank you. Any plans to start a family band? It appears that you have all the instruments covered.
We do have all the instruments covered. Unfortunately, two of our musicians are rather lazy. And don't want to practice.
Are you talking about me?
Yes. No.
Yeah.
Our a 9-year-old likes to play. Yes, but
yeah.
But it's like on his time. So.
And that's kind of how the 14-year-old is too.
Yeah, it's almost how every musician is too. What? Huh? Huh?
Singers.
Huh?
Bunch of divas.
So. I don't know. Maybe when they're a lot older, we might do something fun, you know, if they get their act together. But
yeah, they're right a little now, young. They're a little young right now.
Right now, they're more interested in,
They'd rather play...
this Zelda and Minecraft.
Yeah.
They'd rather build a band on Minecraft than be in a band.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, probably someday, eventually. Aiden just started playing guitar.
Yeah.
Like... just a couple of weeks ago,
yeah.
So he's not really good enough to cover the guitar duties all by himself.
And he's I would smart have to, enough to,
yeah.
If he actually tried.
So I would have to play drums, Nicholas had to play bass, and Angela would sing, and that only leaves Aiden to play guitar, but he's only been playing for like 2 weeks.
Yeah, so.
Maybe. Eventually. Nicholas could play drums, though.
He could, yeah.
And then you could play the bass, and me and Aiden could do the guitars together. And you could sing and play bass.
Okay.
We could make it work.
We might put together something just to see how it was.
I have some video footage somewhere of them jamming together.
That would be hilarious.
Yeah, it's pretty rough. It was awesome though, because they were.
We love our boys.
Brothers jamming.
We're brothers.
Oh man,
we're happy and we're single.
And we're what? They are single.
Boys. Give me a high five.
I was looking. And I think that was it. Anything else? Did I miss anything? Scrolling. Flipside Music says you should come and check out Denver, but that's not a question. Mm-mm. All right. So thanks for all the questions this week.
Yes, thank you guys.
If you have more questions for next week, please leave them in the comments section.
More questions.
Blue Tuesday.
Tuesday.
And we will answer them next week. Now, next week should be exciting because we should have our Chapman guitars by then.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That'll be crazy.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
At last.
So excited. So leave your questions below. We'll do our best to answer them next week. If we have time, it's going to be a crazy week getting ready with the guitars and doing setups and shipping and getting ready for our guitar-becue.
Yes, cleaning.
Yeah, so.
Yeah.
Thank y'all so much. Yeah. Keep the music alive, because if it dies, the world ends. And we'll talk to you soon. Bye.
Bye.
Dainty. He said,
Scare me. Gonna go bake some cookies. Bake them cookies, Lucille.
You're gonna bake some cookies?
Yeah.
You're gonna bake the cookie cup? Like on Epic Meal Time?
No.
Why not?
Cause
that would be awesome. Cookie cup.